Hi, I'm Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. I get questions from people all the time asking me, how do you set up your machine for free motion quilting? So I thought I would show you. So there are some ways I set up my machine, and there are some extra things I use to help make my free motion quilting experience easy, because that's what we all want, right? So let's talk about some of the things that are really important and will really help you make things easier when you're free motion quilting. Now, I have my Janome Horizon Memory Craft 9400 QCP here right now, and as you can see, it's set down into a cabinet. And it does come with an extra bed extension table here, or with a bed extension table, I should say, and it usually has feet on it. Well, I didn't put the feet on because I can just put this right over top, and locks in on the machine, and it fits in really nicely in my cabinet, and it gives me that flat bed that I want to use when I am quilting. And I also have, in this particular cabinet, the ability to flip up a little extra shelf on the back. So I've got all this room that will help support the quilt. So that's the first thing you need to make sure is that you have a flat bed to run your quilt through. And if you need to, you put up extra tables around to help support the weight of the quilt. Now, if your machine did not come with an extra, or I keep saying an extra because it's an extra that'd be included, I thought was nice, but if it didn't come with a bed extension, you may be able to purchase one for your machine. So this is a So Steady table. This is what I use on another machine that I have, and that will fit right around the machine and give you that flat surface and support the quilt. So I'm just gonna put this down the side. You don't need that, and it's very big, which is nice when you're quilting, but not so great when I'm trying to show you other things. The other thing you'll need is something that allows your quilt to slide around really easily on the surface, your machine bed. So I have this Supreme slider. Now, my Supreme slider doesn't look great because it's been through the wars. I've used it a lot. I've actually stitched right through it to the back of my quilt a few times, but that's okay. It still works fine. So there's a little space in the middle. I actually enlarged the hole that was in here, and that's where your needle is going to go up and down. So you want to make sure that that goes around and leaves a space for your needle to go into the little hole, or if you have a zigzag plate and it's a bit wider. I actually cut mine out a bit more, hoping that I wouldn't stitch it to the back of my quilt, but it happened again anyway. So I just took the stitches out. It's still usable. But when you have the Supreme slider, which works very well, the back of it is not sticky to me, but will actually stick to my bed, and that's what keeps it in place. However, if it gets dirty, which is what happened with mine, because it gets fuzz on it after a while, then it can move around. That's what happened and how it got stuck to the back of my quilt. So every so often, you should just clean this. You can just use some warm water on it and pat it dry, and it's good to go again. So that's one thing that's really helpful to have. I also like to use my Machingers. So these come in different sizes. This particular ones, they're small and medium. So these are gloves that you wear, quilting gloves. You can see mine need to be washed. You can wash them, so that's really nice. And then you put them on, and some people just want to use them on one hand. I usually have them on both, but they have these extra grips on the tips that allow me to hold that quilt and move it along. It gives good contact between my gloves and the quilt and keeps it going. So I don't have to grab the quilt or anything. I don't have to force it along. These work really well. So those are two of the things that I like to have that work really well. Two things you have to buy. And I'll put a link in the description below so you can see what I'm talking about and where you can get your own set. It's like a free motion quilting set. But there are some other things you need to do with your machine. So one of the first things you want to do is make sure you have a new needle in. So on my Janome machine, they have these purple tip needles made by Janome, and they work really well for free motion quilting. You're also going to need to have the right foot in. So I'll just show you this one. It's kind of hard to see because it's clear, but you may have a foot that looks similar to this. This is a free motion foot, or you may hear it called a darning foot. That's something you're going to want to put on your machine to use when you're free motion quilting. Okay, then let's talk about the machine itself. There are some things you need to do with your machine to get it ready for free motion quilting. You're going to want to drop the feed dogs. That's what everybody tells you. Drop the feed dogs or not. Okay, so if you're using the Supreme slider, you're already covering the feed dogs. Some machines like to sew better with the feed dogs up when you're free motion quilting, which sounds weird, I know, but they're not in use because you've got it covered with a Supreme slider. So try it with the feed dogs down. If you're not getting good results, try it with the feed dogs up. It might work better for you. It just depends on your machine. The other thing I always suggest you do is that you turn your stitch length down to zero. Okay, your stitch length isn't really active when you're free motion quilting. However, again, some machines will work better if you actually turn the stitch length down to zero. So that's something to try as well. If you have a machine like my Janome 9400, you have the ability to adjust the speed of the machine, how fast the needle is going up and down. So I like to adjust that. I don't want it racing for sure. I have it more on the low end. But what I'm trying to do there is I'm trying to get it at a speed that I like, where that needle is going up and down, at a speed I like, where I can just push my foot pedal right down the ground and just hold it there all the time. So that helps to avoid the that the machine will do, right? So if you get it to a speed that you are comfortable with, you can just push your foot pedal all the way down to the bottom and just hold it there the whole time. That way you don't have to think about your foot, right? You only have to think about your hands moving around. So these are some of the things I do when I'm free motion quilting. Give them a try, see how they work for you. And if you have any tips for what you do when you're free motion quilting, just put them in the comments below. If you liked this video, and I sure hope you did, please click on the like button below the video. And also be sure to subscribe so you'll get notifications the next time we post a new video.